Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Gautale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Prasarine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Pashyatudeshatarine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So what was Prahlad doing? Simple thing. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And what was Hiranyakashipu doing? Intense tapasya, except chanting Hare Krishna. The tapasya of Hiranyakashipu, you can see in his own way he was trying somehow to become powerful. We also today, society is doing that only. All the schools and colleges are Hiranyakashipu colleges. They're making people only Hiranyakashipus. An intense tapasya as well. How much they study? Till 20, 25 years, from 5 years to 25 years, they do so much struggle to become a Hiranyakashipu only, in their own way. They can't become Hiranyakashipu like this. That kind of tapasya, they have no strength. As you can see, he was standing with his hands raised. Shishirada Govinda ki. Om Gyana Divarandasya Gyana Jana Shalakya Chakshur Malitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishraya Bhutale Shimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasate Deve Gauravani Pacharine Nirvisheshaya Shunyavadi Prashanta Deshatarine. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasati Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. So what kind of tapasya Hiranyakashipu was doing? Intense. He was standing with his hand raised, everybody knows. And so intense that ants climbed him. And ants bit his body. It became a termite hill. But still he was not. Still he was not dissuaded. Such tapasya. Whole body is eaten by ants. Still is holding his hand. That is the tapasya. But what is the result of all this tapasya? He was killed by the Lord himself and finished. Does anybody glorify Hiranyakashipu? No. But you have forgotten everything. We are glorifying Prahlad. And unfortunately, we do not give chance to our own children to get something about Prahlad. We push them just to become another Hiranyakashipu. Hiranya means gold. Kashipu means soft bed. Correct? Aren't that's not happening? बेटा तुम क्या कर रहे हो उसको देखो वो कितना पैसा कमाया उसको देखो क्या मजे से रह रहा है हिरण्य मीन्स गोल्ड इज़न्ट इट दे टेल यू नो इफ यू डोंट वर्क हार्ड बेटा वर्क हार्ड यू कैन बिकम अनदर हिरण्य कशिपु कशिपु मीन्स सॉफ्ट बेड फॉर वेराइटीज ऑफ एंजॉयमेंट ऑन द बेड एंड गोल्ड Money and enjoyment. That's the only two objectives of the modern day society. Hiranya Kashipu. So actually whole society is a Hiranya Kashipu society today. And Prahlad Maharaj is something else. People don't even know what it means. What is the meaning of Prahlad? Prakrishta Rupena Ahlad. Who is spiritually very, very happy. So even if people read Bhagavad Gita, they have no idea what is Prahlad. They squeeze out meaning from Bhagavad Gita to justify another Hiranyakashipu only. To justify this nonsense Hiranyakashipu civilization. They twist Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is glorification of Prahlad. People like Prahlad. Bhaktya maam abhijanati. Mahatmanastu maam bharta devim prakriti maashita bhajanti ananya manaso. That's what Bhagavad Gita says. Great souls, Mahatma, are not Hiranyakashipu. What are the great souls? Mahatmana tu maam partha devim prakriti maashitaha. They are covered by Devi Prakriti, divine energy of the Lord. And what do they do because of that? Bhajanti ananya manaso. They are constantly chanting the holy names of the Lord. So this is very important that we understand the very essence of this festival. Don't think that this is old story, it has no relevance. Aatu jada relevance hai. Very, very relevant. We are all pushing ourselves and our dependents into a Hiranyakashipu kind of life. Meaningless life. Okay? So, let us just understand the whole pastime. So, there are so many lessons we can take. This is Prahlad Maharaj. So, when his father was doing this intense tapasya that you can see, Devatas found an opportunity to attack his kingdom because he was the most powerful person there. Brother was already dead. Hiranyaksha was killed by which incarnation of the Lord? Parade. So brother Hiranyaksha was already dead, was also big trouble. Now Hiranyakashipu is there, and when they attacked his kingdom, they found that his wife, Hiranyakashipu's wife, is pregnant. So they got an idea that let us kidnap his wife because another Hiranyakashipu may be born who is so dangerous. So we will lock her up to see if another Hiranyakashipu boy will kill him. But Narada landed up, said, "This is abominable. You are Devatas. To drag somebody's wife in a helpless condition like this, you have no shame. What are you doing?" They say, "No, we have nothing to do with this. But the point we are troubled, the already Hiranyakashipu troubling the whole universe. The child will be another Hiranyakashipu." They say, "No, not another Hiranyakashipu. He is the greatest devotee of the Lord. Even if you want, you can't kill him." That happens later. So they are all Devatas. They have firm respect for words of Narada. And immediately they offer obeisances to Kayadu, to the child. And they do circumambulation and they go away. That is Devata. Devata means firm faith in scripture and the acharyas. That is called Devata. Okay. Firm faith in our own strength. That is Hiranyakashipu. And then she is very worried. So she requests that, "See, they attacked me now. But in your presence, okay, again they may attack." She is the mother. "I am very worried about my child. So please give me shelter in your ashram and grant me the benediction that my child will not be born till my husband comes back." So Narada says, "Your child will be protected." He gives the blessing. Therefore, actually, because of the blessing of Narada, Hiranyakashipu also could not do anything to the child. He blessed him, protection. Nobody can kill this child like this. And then, sitting in the ashram, she came. Narad Muni, the great Paramahamsa, and she is doing little service. You can see like making some garlands, another thing in his place, in his ashram. And Narada is taking pleasure to talk to Prahlad, who's a great devotee. Just like only devotees will like to hear the narration of Prahlad Maharaj. Non-devotees will read newspaper, they will watch movies, they'll watch cricket match, because there's nothing higher to do. Vayasam Teertha. These things are pilgrimage place for the crows. Kowe kidhar jate? Kude danwa jate. The whole society is actually degraded to a pilgrimage place for the crows. Kowe. But Hamsas, they want to hear Prahlad Leela. You see, the Bhagavatam is so beautiful. There is so much opportunity. Now, every day we can pick up Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, we can read. And by hearing, our whole consciousness will be purified. But we have no time. We have time to watch 4 or 5 hours cricket match. We have time to watch movies. We have time to read newspaper. But we don't have 5 minutes to chant the names of God. So anyway, so Prahlad Maharaj is not so unfortunate. He's a great devotee. Even in the womb of the mother, he started hearing Narada. He was already a great devotee. Prabhupada says, Prahlad was a mixed siddha. He was already a great devotee. But by taking blessing of Narada and hearing him, he became a siddha purusha. And he did something which is shows his devotion unparalleled in the history. Father is busy with his tapasya and finally he comes back. You can see, before coming back, he achieves his objective. Actually, generally, the Danavas are devotees of Devatas. Danavas will never worship Vishnu. They will never worship Vishnu. Because Vishnu, you cannot go with all these crazy desires. He will never accept. But Devatas have been given. Devatas are agents of the Lord. They are not independent gods. But they have been given a power, a tawny. Okay, some crazy fellow comes to you for some funny desire. Just like Ravana also ran to Shiva. He could not approach Vishnu. Vishnu will not give him anything foolish. Therefore, Devata, generally people approach. Kama sata hita jnana yajante anna devata. When the heart is stolen by material desires, people generally run to Devatas. They don't go to Vishnu. So he is also praying to Brahma, a Devata, to give him benediction. And Devata, Brahma comes. After his whole body, you can see, is eaten into by ants. Brahma comes up, what do you want? What kind of tapasya is this? No, grant me the boon that I become immortal. Brahma says, I am not immortal. I also have a life. My life may be big, 311 trillion years. My life is very big. But still, I also die one day. So I cannot give you that. I myself don't have that. So no, grant me the boon. What are the boons he asked? I will not die in the day. I will not die in the night. No man will kill me, no animal will kill me. I'll not be killed by any weapon, I'll not be killed. Please, big list he makes, neither inside, neither outside. Like the modern science is trying to fight with the material nature, some or another. Even though the fight is going on collectively, people are put to death. Even the very same scientist is put to death. Nobody can escape. They themselves cannot escape the laws of material nature. Not only they cheat themselves, they're cheating innocent mass of public, again surrender to the Lord. Everybody knows death is coming. So he looks for shelter and they come to the Lord. They say, don't go to the Lord, come to us, we will give you protection. What they will do? We will put you under ice and after thousands of years when we get some clue, we will wake you up. You know, this kind of gymnastics are going. That's not going to help. You will be put to death. Krishna Bhagavad Gita says, I am Kala. Kalosmi, and which destroys everything one day. Okay, so Hiranyakashipu prays to Brahma somehow to remain immortal. Like we are also trying somehow to fight against the laws of material nature. And for some time, Lord allows some fun. You know, he can control so many things. He takes away Indrapuri, he gets control over everybody except Brahma and Shiva in this material nature. Vishnu is not part of material nature. Vishnu, Narayana is part of the spiritual world. Within the material nature, he becomes most powerful, except Brahma and Shiva. And he now starts torturing even the Devatas. He used to catch any Devata and slap him for no purpose. Hey Indra, come here, give a slap. Hey Varuna, come. Everybody he was torturing. And they were very disturbed. They went to Brahma, what is going to happen now? This fellow is harassing us like anything. So don't worry. A great devotee is born in his own house. When he touches him, Lord will finish him up. Lord will not tolerate any insult to the devotee. So that's how now the pastime unfolds. So he calls him, his Prahlad Maharaj, small child, he puts in a Gurukul. This Gurukul represents modern kind of education where there is no talk of spiritual life. In the name of secularism, it is just a Shanda and Amarka school, the school Prahlad studied. Zero talk about spiritual life. Only how to become another Hiranya Kashipu. How to earn money. You see, I speak to so many students, hardly they have any interest to study the subject they are studying. Correct? How much package I will get, how I can become another Hiranya and Kashipu. That's all. Unwanted civilization, unwanted education. And then what happens is that Hiranyakashipu one day calls Prahlad Maharaj and he says, my dear son, please tell me what is the best thing you have learned. So Prahlad Maharaj doesn't tell about the school. You know, what do you learn in the school? 2 + 3 = 5. And parents will be very happy. Correct, isn't it? They feel very happy. Oh, very nice. What you will ask? The small child goes to preschool or any school. What do you expect? Some small thing you will ask. And parents will be very happy. Correct? Today I said CAT, CAT. Oh, you're so sweet. So like that, Hiranyakashipu takes his child on his lap and he embraces him with so much love. And he asks him, my dear child, what did you learn in the school? So Prahlad Maharaj says, what is the shloka? First shloka. Tatsadu manye asuravarya dehinam sada samudvigna dhyam asadgraha hitvatapatam griha andukupam vanam gato yadharimashayeta. Very nice shloka. He said, tatsadu manye. My dear father, this I consider to be the greatest. Sadhu means great. Asuravarya dehana, O best of the Rakshasas, sada samudvigna dhyam asadgrahat. We are all in so much anxiety because we are trying to make a permanent settlement in a temporary place. Mark his words. Permanent settlement in a temporary place. Hitva atmapatam griha andakupam. We jump into a blind well. Vanam gato madharima ashrayata. My dear father, instead of being lost in the materialistic life, which is like jumping into the blind well, vanam gato, you take shelter of Hari and go to Vrindavana. When Hiranyakashipu hears this, that we are in anxiety because we are trying to make a permanent settlement in temporary place. How much knowledge is giving you? We are all in anxiety because we are trying. We are seen in front of us. Our grandfather has died, great grandfather has died. My death is also coming. And we know any moment anything can happen. So much anxiety is there. Every moment we are in anxiety. When anxiety becomes too much, we don't get sleep. But anxiety is always there. So we are always in anxiety because we are trying to make a permanent settlement in a temporary place. Sada samudvigna dhyam asat grahat. Sada samudvigna means always in anxiety. Sada means always. Asat grahat. We are trying to make our house in a asat place. A temporary place we want to make a permanent settlement. We are all in anxiety. What is she to do? Take shelter of Hari. You will be peaceful. But Prahlad Maharaj, Hiranyakashipu, when he hears that, he's very upset. What happened to this nonsense child? So he calls the teacher, says, what's wrong with you? What are you teaching this nonsense? Okay. Suppose any child goes home and says, Beta, what did you teach in school? Mama, they taught Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This is a mantra in Kali Yuga. If you chant this mantra, you'll automatically get all the wonderful qualities of Prahlad. So he requested you to chant. So what the parents will say, sometimes, not all, some good parents are always there, but mostly Hiranyakashipu parents, what they will say? What nonsense have you learning in schools? Correct? Will they say or not? Kya bakwas seekh rahe ho? You have to work hard, you have to earn money. No child studies more than 1 or 2 hours a day. Most of the time they play games, they watch movies. And 5 minutes if you can chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, don't do that.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Hare. We'll be right back. Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Krishna.